Comcast SportsNet.
This week on State Champs, highlights from across the metro area. We celebrate the life of a coaching legend, and we head to Macomb County to hand out the hardware. It's a race to the finish, so don't move a muscle, because
it's next
on State Champs! Yeah!
During the summer of 2006, the Michigan high school football world was rocked by the passing of a legend. This is our chance to pay tribute. It's the first of our Capital Mortgage Funding True Champion segments.
George Sahady grew up on the east side of Detroit and began coaching in 1962 right out of college. That began a 40-year career, 33 at the old Bishop Gallagher, which became Trinity, and later Harper Woods Notre Dame. He lived for those Friday night lights.
He really had a deep love for the game, and he always took care of his family, but I mean, he could have got other jobs, you know, other opportunities, but he just really wanted to coach football, and my mom really wanted him to coach also.
His style of coaching, innovative. His message, no excuses.
He could light you up and dress you down, and you know, and he was old school, and he was tough. He was a tough guy, but very fair.
6 playoff appearances, 5 Catholic League titles, state semifinals twice, the championship game in 1992 and 98, but the game of the year, every year, De La Salle. 15 years ago, one for the ages.
To take the propeller back, that also got us into the state playoffs. It also got us into the Catholic League playoffs, so that one game meant a whole lot.
Talk about a team. George and most of his staff worked side by side for nearly 4 decades.
We just had a good relationship. We worked well together, and you know, it was all for the kids.
Not only did they coach together, I mean, they would get together on the weekends, and you know, they would play cards together, or they, you know, watch Rose Bowl games together, and you know, watch Red Wing games together. You know, they were great friends.
8 former players went on to play at U of M, including Braylon Edwards. Classic story. In 1986, George was invited to be on the sidelines for another Ohio State-Michigan battle in Columbus. As the team prepared to leave the tunnel, Sahady didn't have the proper pass and was stopped by a trooper.
No, you're not with the team. You got to have a special pass. You're not going in there. You're not going on the field. And Bo had heard this, and he said, look, he said, if he doesn't get in, we're not going in. And that was basically, you know, Bo said that, and the trooper said, okay, you know, go on ahead.
Think, Bo. They got to watch you think.
In late 2005, he was hired to coach Divine Child. He passed away before the first whistle, but his legacy lives on.
He cared about his players, regardless of how he made his point. And sometimes, as I said, it was not always smooth in terms of, you know, he was tough, but he made his point and he cared. And that's a huge, huge characteristic.
Ask any former player, whenever they would run into their old coach, these words: if I have kids, I hope they play for you. Indeed.